Hey guys, Wells Knight here, and welcome back to another episode of our Nordic Village Let's Build. And in today's episode, we are going to be continuing work on the Stave Church. Last episode, we got pretty much the first floor, like the first story roof done. And in today's episode, we are going to start working on the second story. So I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to start bringing up these four pillars right here. And we'll just bring those up about five high. And that kind of maps out a bit of a roof shape for us, sort of, kind of. So I think we're good in that respect. Now, I stupidly put away some of the stuff I'm gonna need. There we go. All right. So, we've already got our first layer of dark oak down, which is good. However, we do have to get all of this done and covered in spruce. And we'll have some stuff to kind of work out as well. Because this is the only part of the building that's going to keep going up. These pillars that I just raised. So, that means that all of this stuff over here, we're going to have to do something else with. I'm thinking right here, we're going to knock these out. And I'm actually going to put dark oak right there. And then we're going to go maybe here. And I'm going to bring dark oak pillars up like that. And then this is going to be another little, like, window type deal. One of these high-pitched arches like this. And we'll go one over like so. So we'll have kind of this nice tall arch shape. And we'll do that here. And why don't we go ahead and do that on the other side as well, just right off the bat while I'm thinking about it. Oop. Well, it's fresh in my memory. There we go. There, there. Oh, actually, we want them facing this way. There we go. Up, up. Over, over, like so, and a stair on top. All right, so that's kind of sticking out. And then right here, we'll just run our spruce straight into it, and it should be just fine like that. And then we're gonna put another hipped roof on this. Although I'm kind of thinking we might make that one a little bit shallower. Maybe we'll go slabs on that. Because it's such a big area, that it could get, let's just see. One, two, well, maybe not. We might be okay. Let's just see. If we put these in place, let's just see how this would shape up. So we go here, 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 and then this would be the center, right? Yeah, that would actually work just fine. Okay, cool, fantastic. That's beautiful. All right, so in that case, we don't need to do anything special with this roof. I was considering going slabs, but we'll just stick with the stairs, and I'll bring that around like so. We'll put this here, and we'll put a row of planks on top of it like that. So that kind of comes up like this, and then we'll bring that up one more to there. So we've got kind of this nice hipped roof leading up right there. Now let's go from here to here. And we'll go set 5. And we're going to do the same from here to here. From here to there. So, and that gives us basically our borders. That way we know where we need to stop when we're raising up this hipped roof. So like here, for example, We know that this is going to come out like so. And that's all good. And then right here, we're going to have spruce planks behind. And then up here, we'll have that kind of coming out. Or do I want this like that? I think I like it better like this. Hard to say, actually. It's pretty close either way. I think we're fine like this. We'll go with that one. Okay, and then there. And then on top of this, we put down our stairs. Here we can go with our planks. And we can just bring those all the way across because we know that's how they're going to go. And then right here, we'll do that. There we go. And this I'm not too keen on. I'm not a big fan of that transition right here. This, yeah, I don't know that I like that. We may have to tweak that a little bit. But, wow, I just placed like all of those incorrectly. There we go. It's not horrible, though. It's not horrible. I think we're going to do this. We'll make this little roof right here a little bit shallower. Just a tiny bit. So we'll go here and we'll just bring it up right there instead. So it'll be stairs coming up like that. Yeah, that's much nicer. That's much, much, much nicer. Put some stairs back there. Put those down. And I don't suppose I have any dark oak slabs. Let's grab some of those real quick. And we'll just bring that across. Yeah, that looks much better. Okay, awesome. So that's all good. This side, I'm going to go ahead and do the same thing. And then I'll come back and we'll tackle this thing. All right, guys, I am back. So we're good there. Now, what I want to do is I actually want to get rid of any of these blocks. That one needs to be... Okay, so those need... Oh, that's the side we haven't tackled yet. Okay, so we're just going to get rid of basically any of these blocks that we can, so that we've got kind of a nice... Yep, not those ones, right? Yeah, there we go. We're just going to kind of clear out these back parts here. And the reason we're doing that is that so inside we have these really nice high-pitched ceilings, which we want. We don't want to have this random kind of wall here. We're going to be doing stuff with like balconies and all sorts of stuff. So we need the wall here from the outside, but we don't necessarily need it from the inside. Okay, so there's that. Now here, let's grab, threw away my stairs. There's okay. Let's go like this and see if we can sort out this little part right here. This is gonna be the challenging one because this is essentially a circle sticking out of a rectangle, and it's gonna be a little awkward for that reason, but I think we'll be able to make it work. Bring that here, over like this, there, like so, and then this guy will come around, like that, and slabs on top. That actually doesn't look too bad. That actually turned out pretty good. I think I might even prefer it like that. Just a little bit. Maybe. I don't know. Maybe I do like it better with the slabs on top up here. I mean, then it would match height-wise. It would match this side. I think that's a keeper. I think we keep it. It's hard to say sometimes. Let's just come in here and clear those out that we don't need anymore. And there we go. That's looking gorgeous. Okay. Progress. I love it. All right. Now, we need to bring this up a bit. Because here's where things kind of... Basically, this is kind of where things come together. So, right here... I mean, we've got basically our first two stories done. So now, what we're going to have is we're going to have a couple of different roofs here. So we'll just leave this part alone. Let's grab that and go to here and go you to you and walls. Put those down. There we go. And then we'll knock out these logs in the corners. Just like so. There we go. All right. And the reason I brought that up one was so that we can put another roof on here. All right. But this is the roof where things are going to start to get a little bit complicated because we are no longer doing just hipped roofs. This is where we start to get that kind of super familiar Nordic vibe that we love, kind of like what we have here. This is kind of what we're going to end up with, is a roof like that, but not as dramatic. We'll have a roof that sticks out a little bit, but it's not going to be nearly as this is maybe even arguably overdone. We're not going to have that sticking out that far. So let's bring this up, and it's also going to be a little shallower. It's not going to be super, super high either. So let's actually take a look. How did we do this? We went here, and then it was a stair going out like that. Excuse me. So here... No. Yeah. Right? Yeah. There. Stair going out here. And I think what I'm gonna do is I'll do like half of this and then I'll copy paste it to the other side. I think that's probably the best course of action. So we'll do that up over... Here, there, over. Yeah, that works. That's a simple pattern and it gets the job done. Here, over. And this is our center right here. So I think here we're actually going to bring it out one extra. Or actually here, we'll bring it out one extra and then over. And then here, this is the center. So we'll go there, here, and out. And then up. So I don't think that's quite as dramatic. Yeah, because this was two pretty much on every one. I still want two, though. I just don't... I think I just want the two on the last one. So right here, we'll go over and out. Yeah, that's good. That's good. Okay, so let me get that done over here. We'll do it one more time. So here, over, or out and over. There, out, over. And so on. And so forth. Like so. Until the whole thing is sticking out the way that you want it to be. And then we'll end up probably going a plank, a stair, and maybe we end up doing something like that. That's a really straight line, though. Maybe we do something like that instead. Well, you know what? We can finagle with the end bits and the decorative parts later. I'm not going to worry about that. Okay, so that's all good. And then we just bring these over until they reach... right here should be fine. And then we'll do this part right here. We are going to need a slab on top. So that should be good. Okay. Now, we'll go right here and go until we hit this edge. So that will be 1 point. And then this will be our second point. We'll put ourselves right in the middle and go copy and flip. And then if we come over here, we should just be able to face this way. Oh, actually, undo. Wait a minute. What did I undo? I'm not sure what I just undid. Redo? Ah, I see. Okay. So actually, let me recopy this because I don't want to flip it. I want to rotate it. Flip gets a little funky with stairs. So we'll go there to here. Did you? Why? Ugh. Let me get this sorted out. I'll be back with you in a sec. All right, guys. I am back. We got it all sorted out. It's all good. And yeah. So we've got our end caps on, essentially. Now, what we need to do is we're actually going to have another tower that kind of rises up out of the center of this thing, which is going to be a little interesting. And I'm thinking, where would that make sense? Probably right about here. So I'm going to bring a log across like that. And actually, that just happens to be in line with these pillars. Fantastic. Perfect. That's great. And then we'll put logs down there, copy here to here, and we'll go stack 7 to rise those pillars up, like so. And then, actually, you know what I should have done? We'll go like this. We'll go undo. And let's stack them up with the walls intact, just because it'll make my life much easier. So we get to do that. Now, here, I'm going to go ahead and make my little roof shape thing. Like so. We can go ahead and fill that. Well, do we want to do that? Yeah, we probably do. Which means that I do need to bring this out one more, like that. Well, actually, we might as well just do it by hand. It's not a huge amount of stuff. Could save myself maybe a couple minutes by stacking it, but it's hardly even worth it, to be honest. So we'll go like this. Let's get our planks down in here. And we'll just bring those like that. And put them in here. And then dark oak slabs running in like that. There we go. So that's all good. This is going to actually run all the way along to this side, along with this row of stairs. So it'll be like this. And then we're going to do the same thing over here. All right, guys, I am back. So we've got that done, and it looks beautiful, and I love it. Okay, so now we need to do the top, and this actually could end up being kind of the easy part. Let's go and go here to here. Well, maybe not. Do we want to do... We have a couple options for how we could do this roof. I'm kind of thinking we'll do a roof like this. That kind of comes up and maybe out. Maybe we do the out again. Here. How did we do that? It was over. Oh man, I don't even remember. Started it here. Yeah. Okay. So there. Over. Out. There. Over. Out. And there. Oh, wrong one. Over. Out. And then here. It would be two. Like that. Which is... okay. I think we just stick with one for this upper roof. This is a much smaller roof. So I think we're just going to stick with one right there. Now here, we're actually going to go and make another little thing. And we're basically going to bring this up as well. And I think... 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Ooh. This is going to be smaller. Actually, that's probably a good thing. If we bring that up. Let's just see. If we bring this guy up. Like that. Our roof is going to get complicated, but it'll also look pretty sweet. We could do something like that here, there, bring these up behind. Yeah, this should work. This should totally work. Okay, cool. So, in that case, let's go like that, and like that. Bring our spruce logs across like so. That one goes here, over, out, up, wait a minute. I did something wrong. What did I do? Oh no. I'm breaking things. There we go. Here. Oh, wait. Yeah. There. Over. Right? Oh, yeah. Okay. Got it. You'd think with how many times I've done that one little part over the course of this Let's Build that I'd be able to get it right. But no. That's okay. All right. So we're good there. Fill in our spruce planks. Fill in our... stairs like so, and then we can go there to, actually we need that on top to here, and we'll go to right up against this wall. Copy, rotate 180, and paste. And that should have pasted in properly. Good. It looks right. Looks right to me. Awesome. Okay. So, we're good. This is actually going to have to get copied too, isn't it? That's okay. We can do that. So in that case, let's go here to there. And we'll go right here. Copy. Rotate 180. Turn around. And paste. Oh. And those should now all line up, I believe. Looks like they do. So now we just need to come through and patch up our little, you know, quote-unquote trouble spots, shall we say. And that'll be pretty easy. We'll just get the planks in place first, just because it makes stairs much, much simpler. We'll do that. And then stair. Stair there. That I'm going to do something different with, I think, so we can have our highlight block still up here. So that should all be good. Now here, let's see. We do need a stair there and here. We'll maybe end up running a log there. That might work. But I'm going to put dark oak like this, I think. Or maybe as a stair. Yeah, let's do a stair like this. And then we'll run that across the top like so. And that should be good. And that essentially is like our little stave church, as far as like the structural elements of it goes, anyway. I mean, there's obviously a lot more we can do and that we will do, you know, getting kind of these little like pointy bits kind of sticking out and stuff like that. Do I like it better like that? For the top ones, I think I do. Let's get rid of you. Just to kind of, yeah. Here, I think I'm going to make that a full block. And we're ultimately going to have like a, probably a cross on top here. Some sort of religious symbol, almost certainly a cross, in fact, because I mean, stave churches were Christian churches, historically, anyway. Here we'll go like so, and out. Like that, I think. Same right there, and out. And then on these front frames, I think I'm going to go up, like that, on these little guys. There, here, oop, there we go, and here, and like that. Oh, I just realized that's... Is something messed up there? Do we have different things? No, I just didn't go... I just stopped right there. Yeah, there we go. That's better. Okay, then let's grab some of these. And I want to work those in over here. And up here. These windows need to be facing like... Oh, man, really? These windows need to be facing like that, though. And that way, when I put this back here, it's covered up at least as best I can. And then we have this nice little bit of depth that we create by doing that. So I think the last thing that we'll do in this episode is I'm just going to grab oak beams and we'll come up here like that. And we'll put a little cross on top. Just like that. That should be good. Now, stave churches actually often had crosses kind of all over the place. So, thematically, it would make sense to have crosses, like, everywhere we could possibly fit them. But I don't want to go too overboard. I think for now, we'll just stick with this one. Although, I am thinking that I want to go with the carved spruce wood one instead. So we'll have like this nice cross, but it will be like that. It'll be the Nordic kind of carved Viking sort of thing. But this thing looks amazing, and we still have a lot of work left to do. We have to do the interior, we have to do a lot of the outer detail. But I am unfortunately very much out of time for this episode, guys. So, if you enjoyed this video, don't forget to like, subscribe, and leave me a comment. I do appreciate it, and it really helps up my channel. You can also find me on Facebook, Twitter, and Twitch. There are links in the video description below, so check that out as well. Otherwise, guys, thanks for watching, and I'll definitely see you next time.